Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Today, and hope you're all doing well. Today we'll discuss three SpaceX updates, starting with Musk offering help to make spacesuits for NASA. Then we'll talk about SpaceX securing another Lunar Lander contract. And lastly, Starship comes in a stunning black and white look. Let's begin our first update regarding spacesuits. SpaceX CEO Elon Musk extends his hand toward NASA to help make its next-generation spacesuits. On Tuesday, a watchdog report from NASA's Office of the Inspector General came into the public. The report said NASA's current lunar mission is behind schedule because of the availability of spacesuits. The agency wants to return humans to the moon by 2024, but the mission could be delayed. The report also said the mission would cost more than $1 billion. In this case, Musk offered SpaceX's service to solve the spacesuit availability problem. A CNBC space reporter, Michael Sheets, posted a new report saying, NASA's Inspector General says delays in spacesuit development are another factor making a 2024 astronaut moon landing impossible. With $420 million spent and another $625 million expected, suits won't be ready for flight until April 2025 at the earliest, he added. In response to that tweet, Musk wrote, SpaceX could do it if need be. SpaceX has already developed their own flight suits. We've seen those suits being used in SpaceX's crew missions. When launched in spacecraft, the flight suits will protect the astronauts if there's a fire or if the cabin depressurizes. However, making spacesuits would be a completely different scenario. Spacesuits are more complex than flight suits because they have to be designed in a way so that astronauts can use it to survive outside of a spacecraft in the harsh environment of space. NASA spokesperson Monica Witt said in a statement that the agency asked various companies in the space industry for providing feedback on purchasing commercial spacesuits, hardware, and services. According to the report, astronauts on board the International Space Station use these spacesuits designed 45 years ago for the Space Shuttle program. Since then, those spacesuits have been refurbished and partially redesigned over and over, so there's nothing new in current spacesuits. The space agency has started three different spacesuit programs since 2007. The Inspector General found and has spent $420.1 million on development since then. Additionally, the report said NASA plans to invest approximately $625.2 million more on developing and testing of a suit. It will be demonstrated by astronauts in the International Space Station. The plan includes additional two suits for the lunar mission, for a total cost of over $1 billion through 2025. The Inspector General said that the delays, attributable to funding shortfalls, COVID-19 impacts, and technical challenges, eliminated the chance for the agency to launch the lunar mission in 2024. According to the report, the spacesuits will not be ready for flight until April 2025 at the earliest. But NASA originally said it would take 2 years for the development, testing, and qualification to complete a spacesuit. Former President Donald Trump's administration announced the new spacesuits for NASA's Artemis program, which continued under President Joe Biden. The Artemis program is expected to consist of multiple missions to lunar orbit and surface. Returning humans to the moon would be the dawn of a new era in the spaceflight industry. So, along with new goals, new technologies, there should be new spacesuits for astronauts. The Inspector General noted that these spacesuits have a multitude of different components. As per that, 27 countries are involved in supplying parts for the spacesuit. At this point, Musk suggested that the process is too complicated. He tweeted, "Seems like too many cooks in the kitchen." As per now, we do not have the details about what kind of spacesuits SpaceX will be making. Musk always has some interesting ideas that we see in many cases. Considering that, SpaceX's new spacesuits could have multiple features loaded in it. Musk did not declare whether the company has begun work on its own spacesuits, so it would be a long time before they reveal its specifications. Apart from SpaceX, nearly 50 other companies expressed interest in NASA's Artemis program to develop spacesuits and spacewalk services. Let's move to our next update on SpaceX's third Lunar Lander contract. SpaceX remains unstoppable after securing a third Lunar Lander contract, this time from Intuitive Machines. On Tuesday, commercial Lunar Lander developer Intuitive Machines publicly announced that its IM-3 lander mission would be launched on SpaceX's Falcon 9 rocket in 2024. The next job is to safely carry up to 130 kilograms of payloads to the lunar surface, which will be done by the Nova C lander. However, the company did not yet select a landing site for the mission. Intuitive Machines previously selected the same vehicle to launch its IM-1 and IM-2 lander missions, which are currently scheduled in the first and fourth quarters of 2022. According to company spokesperson Josh Marshall, the IM-3 award is a new contract from the company. It's not based on the previous contracts. The company did not disclose the terms and conditions for the mission in that announcement. Intuitive Machines' first two lander missions are an extension to NASA's Commercial Lunar Payload Services program, so it will carry out the task orders for the agency. Unlike IM-1 and IM-2, the IM series mission is not linked to NASA's Commercial Lunar Payload Services program. Marshall stated that the mission has an open manifest for commercial and civil customers. Steve Altemus, president and chief executive of Intuitive Machines, said, "Our turnkey solution for delivering, communicating, and commanding customer payloads on and around the moon is revolutionary. Now we're proving we can do it at an annual cadence." In addition, for payloads on the lander, the company says it has an excess capacity that accommodates 1,000 kilograms of payloads on a rideshare dispenser ring that deploys into a lunar transfer orbit. From there, it can make its way to the lunar orbit or other destinations. Intuitive Machines' first contract, IM-1, was originally scheduled to launch in late 2021, but in an April filing with the Federal Communications Commission, it stated that the launch has been rescheduled to the first quarter of 2022. The filing said the launch was pushed due to that unique mission requirements, but both companies didn't disclose what those requirements were. When it comes to NASA's Commercial Lunar Payload Services program, SpaceX's winning streak remains intact. As per now, the agency planned for 6 Commercial Lunar Payload Services program awards, and all of them are launching on SpaceX Falcon 9 or Falcon Heavy vehicles, except Astrobotic's first Peregrine lander, which will launch on the United Launch Alliance's Vulcan Centaur rocket in 2022. Let's take a look at today's last update, and that too is about Starship. SpaceX's next Starship prototype, SN20, gets a classic look in a black and white photo shared by Elon Musk. The photo appears to be taken on Wednesday, the 4th of August, when the company was stacking SN20 on top of its first stage Super Heavy booster. That day, it became the biggest assembly in the world. The Starship, on top of the Super Heavy booster, stands 395 feet tall, which exceeds the height of NASA's famous Saturn V moon rocket, which was 363 feet tall. In that picture, we can see a clear view of two edges of Starship and Super Heavy vehicle, and between them, a group of engineers are sitting. The picture looks like a reincarnation of the famous black-and-white lunch atop a skyscraper photograph taken by Charles Clyde Abbott on September 20, 1932, during construction of the Rockefeller Center in Manhattan. In several tweets regarding that picture, Musk wrote that it is an honor to work with such a great team, and added that it's a dream come true to see the Starship stacking on top of a Super Heavy booster. Now all is left to see the Starship blasting off from the ground in its first ever orbital flight attempt. That will be the first step of sending humans to Mars. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.